go.
Hello everybody, my name is June and I am the dog groomer. And today we have a pit bull named Bentley. He's a new client, just came in, 8 years old, never been groomed, nails are overgrown, you know the story. But okay, this table here, this side is really the side that I'm supposed to be using on the, with the grooming arm, broke off because of a pit bull that I was grooming. A friend of mine actually named Tyson jumped off the table. Earlier I had Bentley on the table and he decided to jump off, so boom, I let it go. When a pit bull wants to get off the table, there's really no keeping them on the table. So just trying to make friends with him, trying to get him to trust me and build some rapport so that we can go ahead and try to get him groomed today, or brushed out at least, and his nails done. So, okay. All right. Let's see. There you go, buddy. Earlier, he was just like, what is this? Just, I am not standing off here, but let's see. A little more comfortable this time. I mean, this flimsy thing, for real, come on, this is gonna keep him on the table. So I try not to rely so much on the tools and rely more on the relationship, you know, the trust that we have to keep him on the table. Because really, if he wants to get off the table, boom, and then my other side of the table is gonna be broken. All right, buddy. And just to start off with, because he's never been groomed before, I'm going to use a little pin brush. So, just to let him feel good, like, okay, this is what this guy wants. Oh, okay. Oh. Definitely not what I wanted. Oh my goodness, no wonder you're single, buddy. Nobody likes a kiss like that. All right, I don't know if he's single or not. I don't know. Okay. Hey, relax. Okay. Okay. Puh. I got like full on tongue that time. Good. Hey, relax. Oh my goodness. But this is how a pit bull will attack you. Okay, hey. All right. Okay. And here's the thing though, my dog Dexter, who's also like a blue pit mix, I mean this guy's like a real pit, but Dexter is a blue pit mix. Oh. He was a lot like this in the beginning. Ugh. I just couldn't keep him on the table. But, you know, the more they get used to the activity, they understand what it's for. But, you know, the very first time after 8 years. All right. And so basically, next time I get him on the table, I'm going to go ahead and try to clean his ears at least. Probably, it's gonna happen. You gotta think positive. Breathe, visualize it going well. See it going smoothly. Bentley's gonna stand on the table. He's gonna be calm, cooperative. I'm gonna go ahead and clean his nails, and trim them up. And here we go. All right, buddy, back on the table. You're doing so good. There you go. Oh, back on the table. There you go. Whoa. Good boy. Oops. I missed, but it's okay. We're trying to get his ears cleaned up. Maybe cotton balls in the trash can.
Okay.
The reason why I'm using ear cleaner to clean his nails is because it's a lot of times this brown stuff around here, especially it's been licking it, that causes bacteria. A lot of that is bacteria growing. So ear cleaner, especially the natural green ear cleaner made by EnviroGroom. I didn't get paid to say that, by the way, but EnviroGroom makes a really good natural ear cleaner, and it zaps bacteria. So whenever I see bacteria on the foot, it means a lot of times they're licking it. It's probably irritating. Oh. All right. I meant for that to happen. That right there was supposed to happen. I'm gonna think of a reason why real quick.
Oh, God. Shoot.
Yeah. Okay, buddy.
Oh my goodness.
All right, buddy. Okay. At least you fell on the mat. There we go. All right, buddy. Okay. So, good boy, good boy.
What do you mean?
I'm gonna turn it down. Slick him a little bit. There you go. Get him calmed down. Alrighty. So this lead right here is really just more psychological than anything. It's not really doing much. Cause I don't want to tie it because he's gonna break my table. I can't afford another one. You want to use very soft pressure. You don't want to scrape their skin. So their skin is very sensitive. It's easy to brush burn them. You'll notice a lot of powder and flakes and stuff coming out. And that's all that stuff that was just packed inside the skin, inside the pores. Feels good. A lot of times when you see dogs scratching, I mean, that's exactly what they're doing. They're trying to clear out some of this dead hair and all that stuff that's inside the skin. There you go. There you go, buddy. Now that he kind of understands what I'm doing, dogs are like kids, you know, like that, you know, from another country that don't speak your language. You have to almost with sign language, like make it very obvious what you're trying to do. And just work deliberately. Good boy, Bentley. Alrighty, this is grooming, in my opinion. You know, when I introduce myself and I say, hello, my name's June, I'm the dog groomer. You know, I guess for humans in our world, that makes me a dog groomer by whatever I call myself. He doesn't care what I call myself. He's like, you're what? Okay, boom, I'm out. You know, like, he doesn't care. But the fact that I am grooming him and I'm helping him feel better, that lets him know, okay, this guy's a dog groomer. Good boy. I think I'm not going to push it. I'm going to let him down because he is looking and he's wanting to get down. So I'm not gonna really push it too much because it is our first date. And like my wife and I, when we were on our first date, had I tried to jump her pants, we probably wouldn't be married. But because I waited, but you know, I let it, you know, naturally build up to that. But you know, whenever you first meet a dog, you don't want to ask for too much. Okay, just let him down so he's doing good. So he was looking to jump, wanting to jump a little bit. So, you know, I got to a point where I can now work on the other side, give him a little break.
He just farted.
Well, Pitt's fire, you know, Dexter, he dropped some bombs. But all right, so we're just gonna give him a little break, put him back on the table. So now he's getting used to it. Every time he gets on the table, he does a little better. So finally, we're gonna get his whole body brushed out, get some coat conditioner on him, getting feeling nice, you know, looking nice. And then we're gonna address the nails, because the nails are gonna be where he may, you know, he may flip out. So, and then you may see me flip out. No, I was kidding.
Stop it.
Okay. Alrighty. As groomers, we're artists, but sometimes we become martial artists. From outside again, just take his mind off of it, go outside and do another activity, and then we can do this activity again. And then his coat actually feels much better just going through with the rubber curry brush. And I like rubber curry brushes on short coats because it just helps grip that dead undercoat, that cottony soft stuff, and just pull it right out. And as we pull that out, we'll be pulling out the natural oils that are inside those pores being secreted by the sebaceous gland. And those natural oils are now being evenly distributed throughout the coat and throughout the skin. So that's going to keep his skin nice and moisturized naturally. It's going to keep his coat looking nice and bright and shiny. It's going to repel dust and debris, almost like a self-cleaning coat. So just keep him looking nicer. So lots of benefits for brushing a dog, and also, you know, just getting used to being brushed. He actually really enjoys it. He doesn't like to be on the table for long. It looks like he doesn't like to be told what to do, even on the walk outside. Really didn't like being led. Okay. There are some problem areas down here, but we'll address those areas as he gets better on the table. Okay. Really, he's given me a lot so far. Whoa. There you go, buddy. He's given me a lot so far, so you know, we'll just go ahead and take what we can get. Got the ears clean, got coat conditioner on him, got his entire body brushed out. There we go. Now we can move on to his nails. Ready? Yes, ma'am. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Shh. You're okay. Wow, his nails are long. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Okay, good. You see, buddy? I'm just trying to get the quicks. I mean, just get the tips, not the quicks. I'm really just trying to get the tips so that I don't get the quick. Because, you know, he's already kind of nervous and everything on the table. It's taken a lot and a long time to get him to this point. So, you know, last thing I want to do is accidentally make him bleed and hurt. He's going to be like, I knew it. I knew this guy was up to no good. Hey, hey, hey. Done. Trusted him and quick to nail. There you go, buddy. You're okay. You're doing so good. Okay. You're okay, buddy. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Bentley. Good boy. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Alright, can you give me the nail file on me?
Mm-hmm.
That's very nice, Bentley. You're awesome. You're so awesome, Bentley. Good boy. Good boy. Okay, this is a Kong brush, by the way. You can use it for the bath, or you could use it as a carding tool. I even seen it at a petting zoo one time to pet the goat and sheep with. Okay, that was sweat. Alrighty.
Let me see, buddy.
I just want to follow your nails a little bit.
You're okay.
It's okay. He just doesn't know what it is.
You're okay, buddy.
Okay. Hey, no, Bentley. Okay. So I can get the back nails. Usually if I can get one foot done, then they kind of get what's going on. And I'm not going to go crazy with it. Just introduce it. So that he kind of gets an idea of what's going on. Then next time I can go like real, try to get real close to the nerve.
Okay, buddy.
There we go. I like that comb too. I mean, I like that brush. An obvious little disclaimer, don't do this until you actually gain some rapport with the dog. I mean, obviously, I wouldn't have done this from the very beginning. We've built to this point now. We're bros. I play with his nuts, so we're good. No, I'm just kidding. But, you know, we've built up to a level where he trusts me enough to do this, and I feel comfortable doing it. But, you know, I wouldn't do this with a pit bull just right off the street. You know, pick him up, put him on the table, and start doing his nails. Very good, buddy. Good boy, very good. That was awesome. Yes, that was awesome. Yes, that was awesome. Okay. Very good. Okay. Very good. She bent me. Okay.
You okay?
Okay, okay.
Nice, buddy. Nice.
Good boy.
Hey, relax. Good. You okay? Cool. Okay.
Good boy.
Okay, okay. You're okay, man. Relax.
Good boy.
Good boy. Like I said, I'm not trying to get them perfect. I'm just trying to get them nice and smooth. And also so that he gets the idea. Like, he gets to go through it and feel like, wow, I did it. I went through it. And I didn't get hurt. I guess the same could be said for me, too. Okay. Bentley, relax. Hey, Bentley. Relax, buddy. Okay. Good boy. Very good. Okay, okay. Perfect. Nail, ears are clean, nails are filed, coat is carded, brushed out at least. And the dog groomer, baby. All right. So what did we learn today? let's kind of go over this. What did we learn today? We learned...
Go over to the four-step process.
Yes, that the perfect way, the four-step process is really best way, in my opinion.
Build rapport.
Step one, build rapport. Make sure, and that never stops. It's not like, okay, I got rapport, let's move on with it. You know, like, hey, you know, my name's June, you trust me, I'm a good guy, let's go to bed. You know, it doesn't work like that. So why do I use so many sex references? You know why. Okay. Anyways, it's like, you're a guy, Bentley. Like, broke back grooming, you know? Anyways, what did we learn? Don't judge the breed. You know, honestly, I'll be lying if I didn't, at first, hear I got a big pit bull coming in, and, you know, like, oh, he's never been groomed, you know, like, the nails are really long, and, you know, just... I'd be lying if I didn't say, you know, if I didn't admit that I kind of felt a little bit scared, a little bit anxious, like intimidated, especially when I saw him busting out of the car, poof, you know, this good guy, I was like, oh shoot, you know, but you just gotta keep believing, like season one says, visualize, even though he keeps giving this behavior, just, I guess, keep working towards the end goal, just have the end goal in mind, what you want, a nice cooperative dog on the table, and to be able to clean the ears, file the nails, and they're still a little long. I mean, they're gonna be, but at least we got the nerve exposed. They're a little bit shorter than before. Alrighty. Alright. Okay, everybody. So now this is Bentley, all nice and fresh and clean, and his nails are all done. Oh my goodness. If we could just get him to sit still for a second, you can see his nice bow tie here. I love blue pits because their color, their coat, makes it look like they're wearing a shark skin suit or something. Come here, buddy. Hey, Bentley, come here. We got a nice Thanksgiving bow tie to go with his suit. There we go. All right, but anyways, you know, there's still a lot of issues that we have to work on. Skin issues, behavioral issues, but at least, you know, I say this was a successful first date. All right, buddy? Very successful first date, in his case. Stop it. Man, I'm my own person, okay? I claim me.
He finds you attractive.
All right, we'll be back. Oh, it's just a big baby, you know? Okay, all right. Oh no, look at this. There you go. I did a real good job. That's kidding. Hey, stop.
Isn't he trying to dominate you?
Yeah, he's trying to dominate me. He's claiming me, basically. I mean, Caesar Milan, that was a big no-no in Caesar Milan's book. Look at this. Caesar Milan. Oh my goodness.